love her so. I wouldn't trade her for gold. I'm walking on moonbeams. And I was born with a silver spoon. Hell, I'm gonna be me. I'm gonna be free. Walking on moonbeams and staring out to sea. And if the door be closed, then a row of homes start building. And tear your curtains down, for sunlight is like gold. Yeah, you better be you and do what you can do. When you're walking on moonbeams and staring out to sea. If your skin was soiled, how long do you think before they start digging? And if your life was gold, how long do you think you'd stay living?
You need to lock it up.
I wouldn't trade her for gold.
Oh my gosh, that was beautiful.
That's awesome. I love it. Hey, great. I'm going to mess your makeup up. Sweet.
This is for you.
Thank you. Oh, thank you.
You have to open it.
Can I open? Oh, wow.
Father of the bride.
All
on
right.
This side. And. Says, I will always be your little girl.
I love it. I love it. I got to put them on. Thank you, sweetie. Love you.
Make
be my vision, oh,
got no trouble today. family and friends, I welcome you to this day of celebration. Philip and Katie have invited us here to this place to share in their declaration of lifelong commitment to one another. Your blessings, support, and encouragement, all of you, are important to them and necessary for the spiritual and familial relationships that they will share from now on together. Amid the turmoil of our world, with all of life's struggles and concerns, it is with deep joy and a sense of wonder and awe that we pause to affirm this kind of love that many of you have shared with each other sitting in the congregation and we are doing here tonight. We also celebrate the blessings that all of us cherish in intimate relationships. This ceremony calls to all of us who are married to renew our vows and to rethink our commitment to our life's partner. Let us pray. O God, Lord of life and love, source of all good, giver of all joy, we thank thee for the gift of marriage. We bless thee for the joy that Philip and Katie have found in each other, and for the covenant that they are making before thee today. Grant, O Lord, that Katie and Philip may live together in unity and love all of the days of the life that thou wilt give them. We also ask for them health, prosperity, and peace. Strengthen them to obey and serve thee, that they may walk in the steps of Jesus Christ, and when the joys and sorrows and all the good and evil of this passing world are ended, inherit thy promises and share in thy eternal glory. Lord God, look with favor upon us and all our homes. Defend us from evil within and without, and supply our needs according to the riches of thy grace. Then, directed by thy Holy Spirit, we may look to the good of others and grow in grace as we advance in years. We ask these things through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, saying together as one people the prayer he taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Who giveth this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother and I. Got
you. Good. This is a beautiful day for a wedding. On the way over here, Donnell, Philip's mother, said, well, it's a beautifully warm day for a wedding. And I can testify to you now that is true. I'm thankful that you don't have a robe. I would like to share with you a few texts of Scripture which are familiar to most of you, snippets here and there from the Old and New Testaments. Let us hear from the Word of God. Let us make man in our image after our likeness. Therefore, a man shall leave his father and his mother and hold fast to his wife, and they shall become one flesh. And God blessed them. And God said to them, be fruitful and multiply and fill the earth and subdue it and have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the heavens, and every living thing that moves on the earth. St. Paul said this, look carefully then how you walk, not as unwise, but as wise, making the best use of the time, because the days are evil. Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the will of the Lord is. Personally, I'm excited about this day because I have so many relationships here in this group and in the congregation out there. Family members, friends, my wife Ruth and I, and sons and daughters, and sons-in-law and grandchildren, and greats. So it's a wonderful day. But Philip and his brother Chad, I have watched them grow since they were born, and I have babysat them on occasion. I have attended their high school games and taken them out for fun and food at times. I fed Philip his first filet mignon. Not literally, but he and Chad were with me for dinner one day, and I told them they could have their pick of the menu. And Philip said, "Anything? Anything? Filet mignon? Filet mignon. That's what I want." And that's what he had. And he ate it all. And it was a good job. What were you, 10 or 11, something like that? You don't know. Okay. Yeah. Well, my wife Ruth and I have sat for hours watching Philip swim and his meets, and most of which took less than 2 minutes, and the plays that he was in. So it's been a fun thing to watch him grow. Katie, I know. Time for her, right? I don't know Katie quite as well, not yet. Looking forward to that. She's been in our home one time in Lexington. She won over our family at her first showing. It was obvious that she was a woman of beauty, and she had an electric personality. She was vivacious as an individual. She's intelligent and winsome. All of these characteristics flowed from her naturally, not forced. So she is a beautiful person, but I need to have some help from you who are here tonight, who know her better than me.